And there you go, my flashy intro to the latest Rude Dude video. Here's the piece we'll be working from. A little 3x4-inch black and white image from some old magazine. In these two previous Rude Dude vids, we've shown you a demo on Jill the Cat Lady from Nexus and a Sargent copy using a watercolor and colored pencil. What to do next? Well, what about color? When I've taught classes over the years, I always get, "What colors are you using, Steve?" I get that all the time. Color is not that hard, but knowing artists like I do, most seem to relish making it harder than it is. So here's our black and white photo to see if we can turn this into a color painting. But we're not going to use the safe and true colors that a color photo of this young girl might be. We're going to exaggerate things. And the weird thing about exaggerated color is that from a distance, it's not going to look as shocking as it would be when you see the colors that I'm applying here. I know, weird. But that's what happens. So here's my palette with my usual mixtures of all that I need and very little of what I don't need. And the handy listing of the mediums that I'm using. White and black are always on my palette, and of course, the three primaries, plus the so-called convenience colors like yellow ochre, orange, and alizarin crimson, which is just a fancy name for a dark red. There's a lot of ways to begin a painting. One way is outline. The other is massing. Today we're going to be using outline like when we use a pencil to begin a drawing. The eye goes here, the hand goes there, all that. If you want to see the massing method, let me know and we'll feature that in another vid. Here we're starting out with a fairly small flat brush and using thinned out paint to draw it in. We'll put the picture we're working from up in the corner so you can compare things. A little dip in the mineral spirits and we're off and running. Now let's throw in a few large dark areas to get things blocked in. We're moving forward with the hair, eyes, and hand to mark their spots. Since I aim to make these vids for people as impatient as I am, let's start getting into some color. Here comes the red, and here's that picture again to compare to. So just watch for a little bit while I keep working on things. Thank you. You can see the paint is fairly thin at this point. I don't like to put paint on thick in the beginning. If I make a mistake, all that paint has to be scraped off, and that's no fun. That's why I start off thin. The brush I'm using here is a big flat brush. I'm also feeling my way through the colors I might be using. That's another reason to keep the paint thin early on. Now back to the palette for some white, yellow ochre, and orange. And let's get back to the photo to see how I'm interpreting things. Everyone likes close-ups, so here's a side-by-side to compare things. You can see some of the wild color choices I'm making with intense reds and even greenish tones in the flesh. And as you just read, we can start refining a few things now. This is where we chisel out forms more accurately and try to keep things like noses and eyes from getting way out of whack. Remember that on any form, there are going to be hard shapes and soft shapes. This young girl's face has a lot of soft forms. I'll be speeding things up from time to time so we can keep things at a good clip. To me, it's funny how you can take all these weird colors and still make something like a face look perfectly normal. I know, go figure. By now, I'm into the swing of things, and it's becoming less work with every stroke. That's the fun of being an artist and learning new things all the time. Our lives are made up of segments of time. I like to use it to experiment and study. It's something I've done since I was 18. Thank you. Oops. When I screw up, out comes the scraper. At this point, the painting is practically done. Just a few more refinements and we'll wrap things up. Another mistake. Out comes the scraper. Notice all the little shapes these strokes are made up of. I learned about shapes in art school and how important they were to things. You don't see it, but I'm also wiping off my brush whenever I change colors, which you see me doing a lot here. And here's the finished piece where we can examine all the big and small details. And there you have it, folks. One exaggerated painting in color from Steve Rude the Dude. What idea would you like to see me do next? Let me know, and I'll get on it.